the sideline watching, so I make them clap it up. Clap, clap, clap it up. Clap, clap. Now clap it up. Down and
activated. Let's swap it in, wanna thing up.
Now it's all back with my brother and together.
These players are on the last year of their
contract. Whoever thought I have a buzz down, still sticking to the script, going deep. Still trying to take care of my people. Football ain't all I know, that was all I chose. Back to the road for me. If I'm provided, doggy, how we gon' need that step? Just let a young no sad step. I never knew my broke down. Ready to see it here, don't hit too low, no, I need my lead. Cause we sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost wrong speak. I'm gone down. Don't hit too low, no, I need my lead. Cause we sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost wrong speak. I'm gone.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot, I had the answer, then forgot I knew one day my pop finance for not, my not, my not for flexing, I fell out and cut the check, my not, my not paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning the day, the dawn of the dead day, I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the nigga, the serpent, determined, the plotting, the threats. It ain't no stopping and run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances, I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts, the world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, do what I do and I say what I want. Well,
yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack in my jacket at Grammy, we see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city, you see the duality. Who tryna battle me, huh?
Hitters is after me, can I be that many? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality, really, it's up, it's up, undoubtedly.
Baby gon' touch the bucks, my salary double. Your baby daddy make me feel in trouble. I did the tackle and the pick and I hustle. I had to have it, had to get in the huddle, in the gravel and rubble.
Got me a sack and I'm tryna be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle.
See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking better, set back and watch. Run shotgun, come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Tryna bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk.
Talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walking block of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Okay.
I'm ready for more.
If you fired up, I'm fired up.
Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3. Hey. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. Game time. I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
I just got 20, I'm running on empty. This mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel the envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of guerrillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
I'm ready
for more. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of guerrillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
Tables and turns.
Forget the bridge we don't build. This time I let them all burn.
They try to count me out. Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the third.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
they count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
Total catch up.
But I still can't even see them from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two.
Proud to shoot.
Designer, drink it what I desire.
Put him out,
it's what I told him, cause that boy, he on fire.
Get that thing and air it up, been in my bag a little bit.
Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't put a little chick.
They say they truly love his paper.
You see, that's some milk.
Where you catch all my brothers ballin', ain't shooting no bricks.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up,
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we don't build, this time I let them all burn.
They try to count me out. Well, now it's the word.
I bring in
paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling.
Oh,
don't count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins
right here,
right now. Catch me if you can.
Never really care what they say.
On God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-chain, cha-chain, rackets, rackets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your plate. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Mahi got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet.
If I like it, then I cop it.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we don't build. This time I let them up.
Today, from TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville, Florida, it's week three of the NFL.
No run back here on the opening kickoff as we'll start at the 25. Arizona Cardinals offense coming out here for the first time, and you get a peek at Kyler Murray, the dangerous offensive weapon now in his third season in the National Football League.
And frankly, this is the type of game that a great quarterback relishes because 0-2 on the road, everything's against him and his team. No one can expect them to win. Sometimes you band together real tight in that situation, and if he plays really well, they've got a chance to get that done. AJ Green makes a nice catch for a first down wearing that familiar number 18, but the uniform a little bit unfamiliar. He did spend 9 seasons in Cincinnati, was their second all-time leading receiver behind Chad Johnson before heading out west to join the Cardinals.
And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And the Jags grab it, and they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
The Jacksonville offense getting ready to begin this first drive, and at the helm, the number one overall pick back in April, Trevor Lawrence, the rookie out of Clemson.
And I saw...
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Now the pass, and it's into the arms of Hopkins. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big play there on the catch and run. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. Second and eight coming up. To throw, it's Murray. Eluding the pressure right. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Kyler Murray, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead. Extra point good by Prater. And it's now a 7-0 game. The drive there only spanning 3 plays. And the play that polished it off was the touchdown run by Kyler Murray. To return, here's Agnew. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. This is James Robinson, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there, and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Off the play fake, here's Lawrence. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. And the Cardinals are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. Here's Murray from midfield. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
And there's James Conner with a run that gets everyone's attention. He joined the Arizona Cardinals after 4 years in Pittsburgh. And his best year with the Steelers, 2018, named a Pro Bowler after a 973-yard, 13-touchdown campaign. Mixed results the last couple of years as he's been in and out of the lineup, but with consistency, he can still be an effective runner.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Throwing again on second down, Murray. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now Green, staying on the ground. Let's hope he's all right. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Murray to throw on third and 1. to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, it's still early in the game. No sense taking a chance on third down and forcing one into traffic. So I like the wise play he made there. Get it to the sideline out of bounds where no one's going to have a chance at it.
And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win.
Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Murray giving to Connor on the option. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. He's got Green. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and 6. The gun. Here's Murray. This is caught. It's Kirk. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. To throw is Murray. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
I think you put just a little bit too much heat on that one. When you throw it to the outside, you do have to be careful because you got to keep it away from the defender. But you also have to give your own guy a chance, too.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Here's Murray. Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. James Conner, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. Prater for the extra point. And that makes our score 17-0. A drive that time of 6 plays. And it winds up in a touchdown for Arizona. To return, here's Agnew. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. I'll try and get things settled down a little bit.
From the 38, Lawrence. It's complete to Robinson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They'll run on first down. It's Robinson. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. They go play action now. Lawrence. And here's another interception, the 3rd of this first quarter. Buda Baker with a pick. And the Cards are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense.
They've been off to the races already. A 17-0 lead. Now a chance for more here as they've got it first and 10. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Now Connor. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. Our score after one. Throwing on second and 8. Murray. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. The Cardinals on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for it with Connor. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 53 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. They'll fake it to Connor. Now Murray. Now he's flushed out left. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And Murray with a smart move there at the end of the play. Picks up the first down and then slides to the ground. Murray now to throw. Quick hitter here. It's complete. That catch good for only a couple. I know when you got a top tight end like this, you want to get him involved, but when you do, you're hoping for more than that.
You certainly are. You've got to try and get him some space where he can make a play downfield.
And he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. James Conner with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cardinals are able to add on to their first half lead. Extra point good by Prater. And the rout is on here in this first half. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it was a touchdown run by James Conner that was the exclamation mark. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. And this one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football. Nearly a 4th pick of the ball game. On 3rd down, Lawrence. Incomplete.
I know this offense was expecting to do big things, but it certainly hasn't turned out that way, at least not through the first 3 drives. They're definitely going to have to put their heads together and start concocting some offense that'll move the ball downfield.
40 yards on the punt, 2 on the return, and the Cards will take over 1st and 10. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Throwing on 1st down is Murray. On the slant, complete to Green. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now. Light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
From the gun, Murray. And his throw's going to be incomplete. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for 4th down. A 61-yard attempt.
no good.
Hit it well from distance, but he couldn't work it back in, and this score will stay right where it is. So they tried the 59-yarder and missed it, and now this offense starts just 1 yard shy of midfield.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
DJ Chark, a Pro Bowler and a 1,000-yard receiver in 2019, saw his numbers dip a bit last year as the Jaguars cycled through some quarterbacks. He's happy to have Trevor Lawrence in town and accepts the pass from him there.
And inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit, and they get one here in the passing game.
And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. Here's Lawrence. Finds the open target, Arnold. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And they get a little bit closer here as the lead's down to 3 touchdowns. So the third drive's the charm. They are on the board, albeit with just a field goal.
Yeah, 3 points from 3 drives. That's not going to win you a whole lot of football games. Hopefully the fact they were able to move the ball a little bit can wake up their offense.
And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And the last time that they were on the field, a little demoralizing. Missed field goal. You know, always feel like you want to get in the end zone, but then, oh, well, at least we're going to get 3. Didn't go through the goalpost, so.
It does test the mental processes of a team, though, doesn't it? Because when you miss a field goal, it's amazing how fast they want to turn on the guy kicking the ball. But you need to keep his confidence up because how many times have we seen games where it comes down to a stretch, and guess what? You need that guy to make the big kick for your team to move on or to win a game. Make sure you keep him happy. Make sure you keep him comfortable.
I'm sure you always treated the kicker nicely, though, right?
You know, truthfully, I did.
Good.
I always did because those guys, they won us a whole lot of games.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Now Murray. Caught left side, Hopkins. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Meanwhile, Murray's throw pulled in by Hopkins. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
First down, Cardinals after the catch there by DeAndre Hopkins. Remember, he spent 7 seasons in Houston, now in his second year with Arizona, and went over 10,000 yards receiving for his career last year. Another big season, also tied his career high with 115 catches, none bigger than the Hail Murray against the Buffalo Bills.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Zach Ertz, his first touchdown of the new season, and the Cardinals will extend their lead. Prater for the extra point, and the route is on here in this first half. So that drives seven plays in length, and the Cardinals cap it with a touchdown. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
On first down, Lawrence. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by Mikel Roby Coleman. And the Cardinals are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead, should they so choose. Caught by the tight end Ertz. Some fancy footwork, but not much room to operate. Just up past the 25 and no further. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. To throw again on second down. Murray, that's going to be caught by Kirk. He'll be dropped at the 30. The first broken tackle couldn't bust him free. So we have, and we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week three matchup. The Jaguars with work to do. They trail here as we are back underway on EA Sports. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half. So where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done and there's no going back. And now you have to play this drive by drive. Obviously, come back in this spot, pretty unlikely. But you still have to go out, take pride in your work, and try and put something together here in the second half.
And now here is another interception. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And this one will be brought back to the 22. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. After the turnover, here's Murray on the slant, complete to Hopkins. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
An option handoff given to Connor. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Murray going to throw. On the screen, this is Edmonds. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. So they'll wind up losing 5 yards on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal.
Well, his completion percentage continues to rise with that one. But sometimes you want your completion percentage to go down. Maybe you should have thought about throwing that one away.
I was just going to say, it is easier said than touchdown. Chase Edmonds, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Cards use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six.
extra point good by Prater, and the lead will swell by one more. A drive there of just four plays, and it winds up in a touchdown for Arizona. To return, here's Agnew. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers, they probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays, and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence. Flushed out right. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Well, that's unfortunate, because he had a nice run going. But give credit to the defense. They got a hand in the cookie jar there, CD.
You have to think about vision, finding a place to get down after you know you've gotten all you can out of a run. And obviously, ball security is paramount. In today's football, everyone's coming after the rock. You've got to make sure you protect it and protect the yardage you just gained.
First down, Murray. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Hopkins. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Murray. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. 7 yards, the pickup there. Second down, ball on the 3. First down marker at the 1 yard line. And Murray's going to keep this. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8 yard line. He lost 4 there, and it's third down. Throwing now is Murray. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation. Prater's kick is good. And they're well on their way now as the lead grows even larger. So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for 3.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them 3. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last 2 drives.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal. But... And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Marcus Golden just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. To try again after the sack. Lawrence flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. Big play that time through the air. 39 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. There's Robinson showing the flash. And he takes it down to the 40 with a pickup of 4.
Well, they certainly haven't been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
Eluding the pressure right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Now Lawrence. Man open here is Jones. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Here's Lawrence to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Arnold. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. They'll come up now on 2nd and a yard. Lawrence going to give this to Robinson, draw play. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up 1st and 10. They'll run it now with Robinson. He's going to get 4 out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line. Now a 2nd down and 6. A play fake for Robinson. Now Lawrence. Flushed out right. To be. It's incomplete, so they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. You're going to get rid of it, you better get outside the pocket.
Yeah, you have to get outside of that tackle-to-tackle box, right? Get out there, and then you can do it legally, but he wasn't able to do so, and they end up losing the down as well.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And his kick here is good. And they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. In the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Driving at the line, the Cardinal offense. They're in control here as they start first and 10 and appearing to have righted the ship following that two-game losing streak. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back the line of scrimmage.
Now on second and 13, Murray, quick slant caught by Kirk, and he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Partner, I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
On first and 10 is Connor. Devon Hamilton with the tackle. Connor gonna get it again on second down. And he'll take this for about 4 up to the 46-yard line.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
On third down, it's Connor, and he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44.
And how about that, partner? That happened in a hurry. Sudden, explosive, gets into the backfield and spills the play.
And he was AFC Defensive Player of the Week last week because of plays just like that. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. A first down run not going to get them a whole lot, maybe a yard. Yeah, it looks like just 1 yard there, so that'll bring up second and 9. Second and 9 now from the 21. Now Lawrence escaping the pressure right. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. The Jaguars on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This time they face a 3rd and 2. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Byron Murphy, and they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. They'll start out here with the option left, and he's going to get this one down to the 30. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be 2nd down. Edmonds running out of the shotgun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now, Looking up at a third and nine situation. Murray a give. This is Connor. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards. Back to the 33. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position, really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just three.
Well, getting the three turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach, when he ordered the field goal, please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Rookie Trevor Lawrence and the Jaguar offense ready to take over. They start on the ground with Robinson here. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run pass. Option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
Lawrence's throw here into the hands of Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. He'll find Jones again, complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. So in the Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Flush to his right. Complete to Jones. And he'll be pulled down, and now a late flag will come with it. And that's in the area of a face mask, I think. So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you get that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He didn't, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the officials to see.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. Rolling to his right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. It'll go in the books as a sack and a loss of a yard, but more importantly, it leads to fourth down. And his kick is indeed good. And they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. So he remains perfect, 3 for 3 in the field goal department.
And it's so important for any offense to have an ace like him up their sleeve, isn't it? Because now you know what his range is, and as soon as your offense gets there, you're pretty much counting on 3 points going up on the board.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. Up getting this all the way down to the Jags 38-yard line. A big pick up there on the run. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's a handoff to Connor. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Ooh. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.